Wouter Maan, talk about water on Mars.
So we'll now move to a place where there's also not enough rainfall data, not just because there isn't any rainfall. So this is a place where hydrologists have to look down and not up. So Mars, a lot of people think about going there. There was a big issue because there's not enough water there to survive, but I'm going to help you a bit with that. So don't panic. I did a little research on this. So this is one of the first maps made of Mars by Giovanni Schiaparelli at the end of the 19th century. He drew a lot of straight lines all across the surface, and this led to a lot of speculations that there was this massive irrigation system on Mars of a species that was struggling to survive a drying planet. It also led to some ideas what the Martians did next. They came to us. They started to eradicate us because they had issues with their own planet. Luckily, this was not the case, but there's a lot of things like this on Mars. Huge river systems, much larger than everything we know of on the Earth. So there has been a lot of water there in the past. So Mars might have looked a bit like this, water, oceans, but nowadays it looks more like this. To be precise, this is an actual image from the surface. And honestly, liquid water can't exist on Mars. If you look at the phase diagram of water, you only have solid or vapor water on Mars. There's no liquid. So if you want to go there, you're going to have a little bit of a problem because astronauts, they need to hydrate too. So now we go into with my research. So these are some of those huge valley systems you see on Mars, and they have these strange source areas. Which has led to some speculations that the water from these massive systems, they came from the ground, with these big cracked surfaces there. And I did a few experiments on this. Hopefully this will work. Well, it's fun of having a Mac codec available. Well, I'll do a little interpretive dance. So there's well, there's a layer of sediment, and underneath I have pressurized groundwater. And what's happening in this case, the surface starts to move up due to the pressure. It creates a subsurface volume of groundwater. It starts to break, it starts to crack, and then all of a sudden it comes to the surface. Come see my thing on one of the screens because it does actually work. So this is a bit of a summary of more of the experiments I did. Now here you see what happens. I've did a lot of the experiments and see a lot of these features on Mars, evidence for pressurized groundwater coming to the surface from below. And one of the big implications here is that all these things there, the water comes from below, so it's not governed by atmospheric conditions or conditions at the surface. So a long time ago, this aquifer got confined, got pressurized, and who says it's still? It's still there. It can't have been disappeared, all of it. So, if you want to have liquid water on Mars, you should bring in some Dutch engineers to drill holes and dig canals. So this image, after all, might still be a very good idea. If you want to know more, come see me. I've written a thesis. It's almost out. So if you want a copy, come see me. Oh, thank you.